Thank the gentlewoman for yielding. Mr. Speaker, how soon we forget. If the movie The Big Short made you mad, and I hope you've seen that movie, then what the Republican House leadership is proposing today should make you furious. After the financial crash in 2009, we acted, the Congress acted. We understood that we didn't have a holistic picture of the risk across the financial markets before the crash, so we made a decision to create the Financial Stability Oversight Council, FSOC as they call it, to police these too big to fail companies and to rein in the risk in our largest financial institutions. Now, some of the biggest banks want the oversight to stop so they can bring back their risky, anything goes casino banking practices, the exact practices that tanked the housing market and destroyed retirement savings for millions of Americans in the 2008 Wall Street collapse. This bill, H.R. 3340, pushed by Republicans and their big bank patrons, will neuter this important oversight body, blindfolding our government again and making another economic meltdown more likely. I feel as though every couple of weeks, the Republicans here in the House are giving us another memory test. They bring a bill up that tests whether we remember that just 7 years ago, our financial markets crashed because of risky behavior on Wall Street. I remember that that happened. Democrats remember that that happened. The American people remembered that that happened. Apparently, the Republicans in Congress do not remember that. But we're going to keep passing this memory test and pushing back against these kinds of efforts to water down the Dodd-Frank reforms. And let me ask this, Mr. Speaker, how many of your constituents, I know none of mine, have asked to gut the Financial Stability Oversight Council, to strip critical oversight of our nation's largest financial institutions, and to make another financial crash likely? Nobody's asking for that. Americans deserve better. They see day in and day out a Congress out of step with their priorities, and they want change. In fact, right now, thousands of Americans are engaging in direct action on the Capitol grounds, asking for campaign finance reform and restoration of voting rights. Instead of voting once again to support the big banks and Wall Street, we should be listening to them and taking action to restore their voice in politics. I urge my colleagues to push back against congressional amnesia and to oppose this bill, and I yield back.